But I believe that in this season of time, God's going to activate dunamis strength inside of us. I want to read you Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. And I want to give it to you in King James or New King James. It says this. It says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. How many of you know that scripture? Okay, I want you to stand to your feet, and I want to pray this and decree this over you, because I believe that this is what Paul had in mind as he began to speak the dunamis power of God over the people in Ephesus. Ephesus was a city that was crazy with idolatry, crazy with witchcraft, crazy with the occult, all kinds of evil, wickedness, and yet God raised up a mighty church in that place. And this is what Paul declared over them. Lift your hands up. He said, be supernaturally infused with strength through your life union with the Lord Jesus. Stand victorious with the force of his explosive power flowing in you and through you. Put on God's complete set of armor provided for us so that you will be protected as you fight against the evil strategies of the accuser. Your hand-to-hand combat is not with human beings, but with the highest principalities and authorities operating in rebellion under the heavenly realms. For they are a powerful class of demon gods and evil spirits that hold this dark world in bondage. Because of this, you must wear all the armor that God provides so that you're protected as you confront the slanderer, for you are destined for all things and will rise victorious. Amen. How many agree with that? Amen. So if you agree with that, we're going to make this decree. I want you to read this decree with me. Okay. We're going to do some decrees. We're going to open our mouth with a decree. Okay. Decree with me. Read this. I am a dynamo, a powerhouse for God's glory, generating light to light up my world. I am filled with superhuman energy and strength. My body is strong, my eyes are open, my mind is sharp, and my spirit is ready to step through every door of favor and influence God opens to me. The victory is in my mouth. My breakthrough is in my mouth. Miracles are in my mouth. I've got one more page. Say this with me. I walk in supernaturally infused strength and apostolic anointing to initiate change and advance my dream. Explosive power flows in me and through me. By the power of Christ in me, I am rising up in victory to overthrow the accuser and break through barriers. I am destined for this and will rise victorious. Come on, can you give the Lord a shout of praise? Amen. So what else do we need to reset? Well, I think Pastor Dean sang about this too. Pastor Dean, you did really good this morning. We need to reset our hope. He sang about that, didn't he? Reset our hope. Okay? Hope leads to faith. Pastor Greg's been talking about this new level of faith. And then faith leads to a place of supernatural miracles, okay? Listen, if you can't hope, you can't dream. And how in the world do you expect to succeed beyond your wildest dreams until you start having some wild dreams? Come on, Bishop Hamon dreamed this place when we had $0 in the bank. Come on, don't limit your dream based on your bank account, okay? Now, we understand, we know some familiar scriptures about hope. It actually says, now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, Hebrews 11:1. Let me give it to you in a different translation. I love to do that because it kind of gets us thinking about familiar passages just a little bit differently. It says, now, faith brings our hopes into reality and becomes the foundation needed to acquire the things we long for. It is all the evidence required to prove what is still unseen. Verse 6 goes on and says, and without faith living within us, it would be impossible to please God. For we come to God in faith, knowing that he is real and that he rewards the faith of those who passionately seek him. Come on, we got to be passionately seeking him during this time, all right? It's not just a matter of just praying through a prayer list. We've got to be passionately seeking him during this time, and it promises us that God will reward those. Do you realize that Martin Luther King Jr. actually said, "Only in darkness can you see the stars." Come on. And I really felt like one of the things God wants to reset is God wants to break any place that hopelessness has tried to find a home. We are never helpless and we are never hopeless if we're in Christ. God always has a plan to get you out of whatever you feel you've gotten in yourself into. Come on, how many think that before COVID ever happened, God had a plan for his church? God had a plan for this nation. God had a plan for the nations of the world. God had a plan for your family. God's always got a plan, and he's always got a plan to bring people out of their pain. Now, let me say that pain is a dream stealer. When you're in pain, it kills your dream. It kills your ability to dream. Whether it's physical pain or emotional pain, pain will have will come in and try to rob you of having that capacity to dream for a different life, something better, something different. And you know, years ago, we had a man that's in our church that's now up in our Dothan church, David Monteleone, and he had terrible back pain, like debilitating back pain, couldn't get out of bed. He's a strong, tough guy, but I mean, he just lived in a lot of pain. And he had surgery once to fix the pain in his back, which did a very effective job. But you know what? After the surgery, we talked to him. We went to see him and we talked to him. And we said, "How are you doing, David?" And he said, "Well, I'm in pain. I'm in a lot of pain after the surgery." But he said this. He said, "But I've got pain with hope now." Come on, how many know pain with no hope is a whole different thing than pain with hope? And sometimes we go through painful times in our life, but if we can go through those painful times and keep a vision of hope of what God wants to do in us, through us, and for us in that season, it helps us to move through the painful time to the other side. Let me read you something that was said by Dr. McNair Wilson. He's a famous cardiologist, and he said this in his autobiography that's called Doctor's Progress. He said, "Perhaps the greatest psychological, spiritual, and medical need that all people have is the need for hope. Hope is the medicine I use more than any other. Hope can cure nearly anything." How many think maybe a good new dose of hope would do us all a bit of good? Come on, hope that produces faith, faith that produces miracles. Amen? So let's look at Romans 15, 13. It declares this, and we've been reading this a lot. This is the scripture out of the New King James. It says, "Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." How many want to abound in hope? This is what this word abound means. It means to superabound in quality and in quantity, to have excess, to exceed, to have enough, to have more than enough, to have more to spare, to increase, to have leftovers. Come on, how many want to have enough hope and then have some left over? Okay? To overflow, to furnish one so richly that they have an abundance.